instead. Today we are on Vaishakha Purnima meditation. This sidereal spiritual karmic healing meditations brings us to a place where we can align ourselves with time and deep into an energetic process of healing. Today, the doorway is taking us to dive deep, very deep, this lunar month of Vaishakha is cleansing very profound vibrations. Let's open ourselves to this cure. Once again, let's become aware of the breath. Observe the temperature of the breath. Observe the rhythm of the breath. Observe the deftness of the breath. Observe the length of the breath. And let's become aware of the surrounding, the sounds, the flavors. Everything that is around us is part of this process. If in this very moment the garbage is being taken out, let us open ourselves. That our inner garbage may be taken and removed from deeper layers of our consciousness. Let's once again invite the emotional mind to be present. Previously, on Chaitra Purnima meditation, our emotional mind went through strong, powerful pressure and heat. Huge process of stress. And during, throughout, major stress, leaded us to a diamond place. Where we see purpose in standing in stressful situations. Once again, please let come a very stressful situation that occur in your life. Observe the breath. Observe the different happenings that go through your breath under stress. As we bring consciousness to the breath, prana goes back into its place. And by the presence of prana, our breath naturally starts to change. Observe the emotional mind, manas, visiting a very big stressful situation in your life. And just keep your attention to the breath. The duty of prana is to be healthy. Our duty is to create the proper environment of awareness where prana can sit. By observing the breath, we create room for prana to heal ourselves. Maybe your posture will be a little bit fixed during this process. By its own presence. Prana will set alignment in the spine, relaxing some muscles, tightening others. So that our spine can be a little bit more fluctuating inside our body. Paradise is just a matter of a spine fluctuating inside the body. Again and again. We invite awareness to the process of breath. Some sensations, some feelings, some emotions. Some thoughts, some memories might come. When they come, again and again, puna, puna, we become aware of the breath. We install prana in our spine. And just by its grace, little by little, health again starts to flow. Today, we are going to face fear. We are entering the cave. There might be serpents, there might be scorpions, there might be lions. There might be spiders. Today, we are going to stay in front of death. Observe your breath. Observe the difference in the temperature now. difference in the rhythm. Observe the patterns changing and let them be. Let's go through it. Our body is in a safe condition. Our mind is allowed to dive into fear. Let's take the hand of fear. The fear of death. This death can be by health conditions. This death can be because of relationships. This death can be because of financial, material reasons. This death can be because of spiritual guilty. Any of them is enough for us to feel the difference in our breath. Please be brave and invite death to be present. Death is a very powerful entity. Either we reverence it, either we fear it. We have only these two choices. Once again, be with the breath. Observe many differences in the parameters of breath now. There can be some thoughts coming about this and that. They're welcome. They are doorways for us to go deep into the emotions. Sometimes the prana is stable and our spine aligns itself. Sometimes Sometimes the prana gets disturbed due to the emotions. And our spine starts to bend somehow. Either in one situation or another situation. Just bring again and again. Puna, puna. Presence to the breath. The fear of death is only a fear about I and my. I have to do this. My family has that. I have to do that. My job has to do that. I have to do that. My whatever, whatever. Observe. The hell of I and my in front of death. Actually, we are suffering due to I-ness, my-ness, state of vibration. Let's get cooked and fried in the hell of I-ness and my-ness. See the emotions coming. Oh, if I die like this, I will not have done that. Oh, if I die like this, my mission in this world will not be complete. And all the frying. Boiling our ego. Now, let's take again the hand of death. This other hand is the hand of service. This life is properly lived with the vibration of service. we take is an opportunity to serve. Serve your family, serve your health, serve your city, serve your job, serve your country, serve humanity, serve the planet. Observe the state of the breath while we are serving. See if there is any sensation of being smashed or expanded when the breath is being illuminated by service. And remember that we are still talking about death. Observe this cooking of death with service spices. Just as hell is available by I and mine to the consciousness, paradise is available by service. To move into spirituality is to move into service. But before we move into service, we need to be able to dance with fear. Be able to dance with fear. We need to be able to play with death. And when we play with death, with service, there is room for reverence. This life is just an expression of service. Let us become open to this teaching, to this spiritual lesson. Divine purple light is welcome in this moment. In this violet light, our life of service has some time in this incarnation. This life of service is ordained within divine consciousness. And when this time is completed, we hug death and say, "My friend, I'm glad to see you. You came, and now my spiritual journey can move on. We are leaving the train of this life to the station of death. A very old friend. We have stayed together for millions of times. And between one train incarnating here and another train incarnating there, we stay with our friend, Death. Aligning ourselves with time. Time between one incarnation and another. Here we are with our dearest friend that takes care of us between one incarnation and another. There might be some situations where this friend can be so lovely that we get attached to this state of existence. And we don't want to be born again. Let's give a full hug to death and say, "My dear friend, I love you. I really appreciate your care, your hospitality. But now, time has passed, and another incarnation of service is ordained by divine consciousness. Don't worry, I'll be back. And we'll have some time together again. When the time is appropriate for that. Bye bye, dear. See ya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo 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 Bhagavate Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Obedience to all forms of guidance that shine, love, presence, and peace. Slowly and gradually, we can start to move a little bit the body, if appropriate. If you feel to stay meditating more, the process is already fine and you feel that your body might benefit a little bit of mine for 5-10 minutes. With our eyes mostly closed, observing if there is any need to protect ourselves, if blankets and whatever, or not. Let's cover our body with energetic or cloth, and this cloth, your spiritual blanket. Is comforting ourselves with divine presence. We are in the arms of our spiritual mother, spiritual father, spiritual energy. Whatever is more